In this video, I'm going to show you the basics of setting up my table. I'm in my blankets. I'm going to wheel, high sidebar. Inside body, I'm going to type table, tab. The first thing inside table is the TR, which stands for table row. And inside the table row, there's a TD, which stands for table data. So I'm going to type row 1, cell 1. I'm going to make two more copies of these. Ctrl D. O1, cell 2. Ctrl D. And row 1, cell 3. And save. Now in my browser, you will see my table right here. I'm going to copy this 3 more times. Okay, save. Now in my browser, you see the table. Now in the HTML4, when you have a table, inside the table opening tag, you will have some attributes. First one is cells, heading. I'll give you 1. And then cell spacing, also give you 1. And then border, also give you 1. And then width, I'll say 500 pixels, but you don't need to type the word px. Save. I'm going to zoom a little bit more so you can see it. So the cell padding is the space inside each cell between the copy and the edge of the cell. And the cell spacing is the space between the cells. And the border, of course, is the border of the table and also the border of the cells. And the width is the width of the table. So this is the basic setup of a table. Now I'm going to change the border to 6. Save it. Now see what happened is the border of the table has increased to 6 pixels, but the border of the cells remains at 1 pixel. Also look at the style of the border for the table. It has an offset style. That means on the left hand side and on the top is lighter in the right-hand side and at the bottom. So I'm coming back to my HTML and take it back to 1 pixel, save. So as you can see that I have 500 pixels for the table, and each column has divided up the 500 pixels evenly. I'm going to add 1 more table data. Row 1, cell 4. Save. Now what happens is the whole table is now divided up into 4 columns. And this is the row 1, cell 4 column. And it is empty here. Now to occupy the whole space, I can go to the TD and give a row span of 4. Now you see this expanded to occupy the whole space. Now if I want to merge row 2, cell 1 and row 2, cell 2, I can go to the TD of row 2, cell 1 and type call span. Give a number of 2, save. Oh, what happened? Now this one has expanded to take up 2 cells and then it pushed row 2, cell 3 all the way to right and create a 5th column. So since this is call span 2, so I have to delete this. So I'm going to command this out first. Save. Now you see how row 2 expand to occupy 2 cells. And you also notice that the text of row 2, cell 2 has disappeared. Whenever you merge 2 cells, the first cell will have the priority and the other cells will lose all their content. Each table should have a header. So I'm going back to my HTML and type tr tab th table header. I'll say header one and copy this 3 more times. Change it to 2, 3, and 4. Save. Refresh. Now you can see that the default font weight of a header is bold, and the default text align for the table header is also in the center. Now you see this row 2 cell 1 has occupied 2 cells. If I want to split these into 3 different columns, I can do a nest table. So I'm going back to my row 2 cell 1, delete the copy, and put another table here. I'm going to copy this to my nest table. I'm going to have 3 columns, so TR, TD, as a nest, 1. Then nest 2, then nest 3, save. This is my nest table, but it's not occupying the whole cell, so I'm coming back to my table opening tag and type width 100%, save, refresh. Now you see my nest table is occupying the whole cell, and this split into 3 different columns. Now you can go to the border, give a 0, 0, save again. So this is the basic setup of our HTML table. In this section, I'm going to show you how to style a table using CSS. To save time, I have to copy the first table and have taken out all those row span and cross span and the nest table. To style a table, the first thing you want to do is to give it a class. I'll call it CSS TPL, CSS table. And then go back to my head section and put style, not CSS TPL. The first thing I want to do is to give a width of 80%. Now when I expand the browser, you see that's to my second table expand to 80% of the browser, and the first table does not move at all. And then I want to give a margin, 50 pixels at the top, auto left and right, 0 at the bottom. So my table is in the center of my browser and 50 pixels away from the first table. Now, since I'm not giving it any cell spacing or cell padding, I have to give it a border spacing. Zero. Border spacing is replacing cell spacing. That means I don't want any space between the cells. The next one I want to style is the header. So TH, the table header. I want the text align left, padding 8 pixels at the top, seal on the right, 8 pixels at the bottom, 8 pixels on the left. I give a background color, of dark red, and the color of the type is white. Save, refresh. Now you see this is my table header. Next one, of course, is the table data. I'll give the same padding as my table header. Save. I want to separate each table row with a line, so I'm going to give a border bottom solid 1 pixels a dark gray. Okay. Now I still need all these right here, so I'm going back to my HTML and copy this. Cell 4, save. So I have 4 columns for the whole table. So each column will take up 25% of the width of the table. If I want to make column 1 wider than the rest of the columns, then I have to go back to my CSS. In my CSS, I'm going to use a pseudo selector, TD, first child, that means it's the first column, and I will give a width 30%. Now right away you see that the first column is wider than the rest of the table. I'm going to give a different background color to the cell 1. So there will be background. I'm going to use powder blue. Refresh. So this is powder blue. Now in order to align the cell 1 to the center of the column, I'm going to use text align center, and also make it bold and use font weight 700. Also want header 1 to align to the center of the cell. So what I'm going to do is I'm coming back right here, th, also first child, text align, center. Now as you can see, this is not completely centered because I have 8 pixels on the left and 0 pixels on the right. So I'm coming back to the first child of TH and first child of TD and change the padding. 8 pixels at the top and bottom, still on the left and right. Also to the first child of the TD, padding 8 pixels on top and bottom, still on left and right, save. Now this is aligned center. I have 4 rows here. I want alternating background colors for the rows. I mean, my CSS, I'm going to use another pseudo selector. Inf of type, but this time I'm going to use odd, that means the odd row. Give a background. D1, D1, D1. Save. Now just like that, I'm separating row 1 to row 2 and row 3 to row 4. So my table looks pretty good right now. So when I expand my browser, you see my table also expand to 80% of the browser. The next thing I want to do is when the visitors, when they mouse over the table, the table row will change in color. That indicating his mouse is on this row. So what I'm going to do is I'm going back to the TD. In my CSS, I'm going to type a hover for the table row. When the table row is hovered over, I want the background to change to a dark gray, so background. Found 333, and I'll also change the color of the type to yellow. Save, refresh. So when I mouse over, the whole thing has changed to a dark background with a yellow type. I don't like the way how the first column behaves when I hover over the table row. So I have to go back to my CSS and type a pretty complicated CSS rule, CSS table tr hover. What happened to my TD first child? So on the background, pound 00x0x0, and then the color is ivory. Save. So this time when I mouse over, everything looks pretty nice. So the table is pretty much done, but I still need a title on top of the table, and that is called caption. So I'm coming back to my table and put a caption. I just say this is a table sample. Save. So this is my caption and it's part of the table. To style the caption, I'm going back to my CSS underneath the table. I can put it anywhere you want. I just want to organize it a little bit better. I'm right underneath the table. Caption. Font size 2em, color dark red, and margin. I want to seal at the top, seal on the left and right, and 10 pixels at the bottom. Save. So this is my caption. The last thing I want to do for the table, I want to add a vertical line in between cell 2 and cell 3, and also between cell 3 and cell 4, just to separate it a little bit better. So the way to do it is come back to your CSS, TD, nth of type. So this is the third column, so type 3. For the left, solid 1 pixels, pound 666. I'm going to copy this and change the left to right. Save. Now you see the vertical separation between cell 2 and cell 3 and cell 3 and cell 4. And then when I expand it by browser, the table is 80% of the browser and it looks very, very nice. And that's how you set up a table with CSS.